Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. So if you want to learn more guitar licks and learn licks that are going to help you play better guitar solos, then you need to spend time learning about a topic called phrasing. Now, the idea for phrasing is often a mystery for a lot of guitar players because this term is many times thought of as natural talent, like either you have it or you don't have it. But there's actually a real science to this, and we're going to focus in on that on this video. Now, one of the best directions to take for learning better phrasing can come from the study of melody lines performed by horn players. Remember that a horn player has to make space in their playing to breathe, and that space will generally be where the listener can pause to better appreciate the musical lines involved with the performance. So in getting things started, let's listen to an example melody I've composed for this lesson, and we'll hear how adding space and through implementing another topic we're going to discuss called phrasing devices can play a role in the development of your ability to never do guitar licks again without considering your phrasing. Next, I'm going to show you how to play that collection of licks I just used in that melody line, and we'll also dig into the ideas that will really build your skills for mastering the art of phrasing licks and lines. But first, I want to tell you about a promotional offer I'm running for my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here, and if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale, and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5, or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. Now I'm just going to quickly perform this melody for you one more time so you can refresh your memory as to exactly how it sounds. Here we go. All right, so let's talk about this. Now, the example melody here focuses on two main principles. The first one is the importance of becoming highly aware of the musical value that happens when you consciously include longer drawn out notes, and you know, it's that space where you're not playing a lot of tones, you're just kind of giving it a, you know, a little bit more feedback so the listener can really, I guess, you know, take advantage of what these phrases are like that you're playing. It gives them time to pause and think. And these are elements that connect each lick. They include other ideas too, like the phrasing devices. You know, in this example here, our focus is on, you know, the musical space, of course. So we have sustaining ideas and, you know, room for the melody to breathe. And then slides as well as hammer-ons. So what happens is the phrase begins with a pickup idea. It goes like that. It's a 5 and a 7 on 4th string, and then we come in with this 5th fret 3rd string. Then we hit a 7th fret on the 3rd string, we sustain it, and then we bring it forward from 7 to 9, and we sustain that again. You can tell I'm adding a little bit of vibrato on that sound so we can have it sing a little bit. So that's the very beginning. Then the next idea is going to be a grace note slide on second string. We'll just slide forward from 8 to 10, and then we'll go back to 8. Now that grace note slide, remember, that's like a ghost note. We're just ripping in from 8 to 10. It's very quick, so make sure that has really no justification on that 8th fret. We come back after that grace note slide, and we do a grace note hammer-on. And then we have a 7 and a 5 that finishes things off on 3rd string. So, all right, now after that, into the next measure, we have a small 2-note chord idea that is taking place from 5 and 7 there, or 7 to 5, I should say. And we slide that forward as a grace note idea into 9 and 7. So 7 and 5 up into 9 and 7. And we sustain that a little bit, bring it back down. So we have 7 and 5 returning. And then we do that guitar lick that we started out with. That's that 4th string, 5, 7, and then 3rd string, 5. And we do the slide again, the 7 and the 5 to the 9 and 7. And this time, though, we're going to bar. We're going to get these two 5th frets on 4th and 3rd string, and that's going to be a little bit more locked down on the sound of a C major chord that's happening there at the moment. After that, we just return back to that lick again. It's kind of like a theme, you know, occurs in this thing a lot. So we get that coming back. That's the 4th string, 5, 7, and then the 3rd string, 5th fret. And that'll just take us right back to the beginning again. So it's a very sweet melody. It's simple, but there's a lot of space in it, and the addition of some of these phrasing devices like the slides and the hammer-ons and that, it just adds to everything. It just really gives it a much smoother sense of style and phrasing, and that's really what we're after. So the main line of thought to have with this, if you really want to improve your phrasing, like the so-called science behind it, is that you need to think a lot more about the timing of things that you're playing and allow things to breathe a little bit more. Give it space, give it sustain, and make sure that you're adding some, at least some, phrasing devices. Now, we focused heavily on slides and hammer-ons here, but you know, we're going to expand on that as this lesson goes forward. But keep these initial concepts in mind, because this will be your first steps towards better phrasing. Let's move on to a modified version of this example melody, but this time we'll just slightly modify the approach used and we'll test out a couple of new phrasing devices. In our previous example, we did not apply any bending, and so I wanted to for sure bring that into the mix. And I also wanted to expand on the application of 2-note chords, a popular idea used by tons of guitar players, which are also commonly referred to out there as double stops. So let's check out the modified melody now, including a couple of more phrasing devices for you. All right, so let's get started by playing this melody down so you have a good idea of how the modified version operates. And keep in mind, too, that if you're a Patreon member, you're going to get these jam tracks as part of your Patreon download for this lesson. So anyway, here is the modified melody. I'll play it, and then we'll get into learning it. Here we go. Okay, let's get into this. The starting phrase is really the same thing that we had from the last melody. It's that 4th and 3rd string idea where we play 5 and 7 and then into the 5th fret. It's a G, A, and a C note. Then what we're going to do is get into something really nice. It's an octave idea. So if you like Hendrix, if you like Wes Montgomery, George Benson, Pat Metheny, this can just go on and on, Norman Brown, all these guys are really great at using these 2-note octaves. Peter White is another guy that uses them a lot. So really cool sound. It's, you know, you got to mute all the strings around that the octaves are being played on, but it's really just two of the same notes, root and octave. You could strum it with your pick, or you could utilize a hybrid picking with your pick and your middle finger. kind of a nice sound as well. So, you know, try and develop it as a technical attribute that you can, you know, expand on your playing with as well. If you're not very, you know, good at it in the beginning, just practice it for a little while. It'll come very quickly to develop. It's a great technique, though. It sounds really awesome. Now, next measure is going to be a bend that we're doing on the second string, 8th fret. And then we're just going to, you know, go and get a regular 8th fret note on 2nd string. So full step bend there, and then the regular 8th fret. And then what we're going to do after that is a bend on 3rd string. So we're going to have that bend cranked up again, full step off 7th fret. And then after that, what we're going to do is move into some more 2-note chords that have wide intervals. We're doing a coverage here of a G major chord into an F major chord. And to do that, we're taking the 3rd and 1st strings. In the beginning here, it's 4th and 3rd frets. And then we're going to drop down to 2nd and 1st frets. And then after that, we're going to have a hammer-on. And it's going to bring us around. The hammer-on, by the way, is on 3rd string, so open to 2nd fret. And then 1st fret, 2nd string. Just like that. And that idea is like really a carbon copy of what we were doing before with the G, A, C over there. But we're just relocating it to another location of the fingerboard. It's kind of an interesting movement there. An interesting sound, too. You know, the color of the sound changes. After that, what we're going to do is play on the 3rd frets of the 4th and 3rd strings. We're going to slide that forward into 5th frets. And then we're going to do the 2nd and 1st frets together after that. So what's really interesting about that first one with the 3rd frets is we're playing an F and a D, which is kind of, you know, interesting on a G major triad because it's influencing the sound of a G dominant 7th chord. So we're adding a 7th extension there. Really kind of a cool effect, and it's something that's kind of getting away from the premise of this lesson, because in this lesson we're talking mostly about, you know, adding the musical space and then getting into these technical concepts with phrasing where we're having the phrasing devices. But that's another really interesting thing to get into as a whole other topic is, you know, the kinds of note choices and extensions and so forth that you can play to just modify the sound. But anyway, that brings us really to the end of that melody example, and we're just going to do the turn around lick one more time after that. So it's really quite a nice sound. Very smooth effect. It's really, really cool. Lots of interesting, you know, phrasing devices that are going on in there, and lots of food for thought, you know, to go forward with. I think that when we move on to the Patreon video with this stuff, something in there that's going to be quite interesting is we're really going to dig into the world of using legato. And if you're not familiar with that technique, you're really going to want to watch that stuff and develop that in your playing. It's just simply not used enough by a lot of the, you know, players that are maybe outside of, you know, rock and metal. You know, it's used a lot in rock and metal, but it's not, you know, utilized enough by, you know, your average everyday guitar player in a lot of other styles. So we're really going to, you know, expand your horizons there in the Patreon video. But take the things that we've covered here in this video and try to add them in your playing as quickly as you can, because it doesn't take long to begin making these kinds of playing shifts, and the effect of it is just utterly fantastic for your sense of feel and phrasing when you're doing lead lines. Well, if you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon supporters, you'll get to watch this lesson's part 2 video, where I'll be covering one of the guitar's coolest sounding phrasing devices called legato technique. Along with the bonus video, as a Patreon member, you'll also get a jam track, plus you'll get to download a detailed PDF handout, and it is detailed. It contains everything that we do here in the YouTube video, plus everything that we're going to be covering when we get to that Patreon video as well. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Well, guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. The comments are great for if you have extra questions that you want to ask, if you want to make a suggestion about future topics that you want me to cover in upcoming videos, or if you notice that somebody made a comment asking for help on how to execute some of these ideas and you can help them, definitely leave that in the comments section. And the thumbs up really helps the YouTube video get more views, so definitely give me a thumbs up there. Also, remember, if you're looking for for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos. It's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got a complete beginner's program, there's a fantastic intermediate course, and an excellent advanced guitar players program. Plus, there's a ton of electives. You can study acoustic guitar, you could do music reading, you could do ear training, you could study guitar technique and guitar soloing, and there's tons of stuff on there. Go check it out. It's at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.